The number one complaint of people with a hearing loss is hearing in noise. As hearing care professionals, we have developed tools to assess this challenge. The first tool in our toolbox is the Pure Tone Audiogram. It defines the quantity of hearing, and we use the results to set the gain characteristics of hearing aids. Although it is an essential part of any audiological assessment, it has been shown time and time again that the Pure Tone Audiogram is a poor predictor of how well a patient will hear in noise. We then have speech testing in quiet. These tests define the quantity of speech the patient has access to, with or without their hearing aids. They give useful information, but only tell one half of the story, as noise is not considered during these tests. Lastly, we have speech in noise tests. These are our true tests of measuring hearing in noise ability. However, these tests can be difficult for clinics to include in their practice for several reasons. They can take a significant amount of time to perform. These tests are language dependent, requiring validated speech materials to be created for every language. A complex, multiple speaker setup is required to produce realistic results mimicking real-world situations. And finally, hearing care professionals report that it is difficult to know how to use the results of these tests to alter the settings in the hearing aid. ACT overcomes all of these challenges. ACT stands for Audible Contrast Threshold. ACT is not a tone test or a speech test. Instead, it uses modulated noise signals to define how much contrast a patient needs to hear the difference between two sounds. It measures the patient's real-life ability to hear in noise. ACT only takes 2 minutes to complete and uses the same equipment as Pure Tone Audiometry, a set of headphones or insert earphones, and a push button. ACT is simple to learn, for the patient and the clinician. As it does not use speech material, it doesn't matter what language the patient speaks, meaning those who enter your clinic who do not speak your native language can still be tested. Lastly, the test is also automatically adjusted to account for the patient's hearing loss. This means that for the first time, we get a quality measure of hearing in noise ability that can be used in all clinics across the world. The result from the ACT test, the ACT value, can then be used to guide how the hearing aid's adaptive features should be programmed. The ACT value can either be directly prescribed into the hearing aid fitting software for automatic programming, or adjustments can be made manually using the ACT counseling guide. So how does it work? ACT uses a modulated noise signal to measure hearing in noise ability. Let's listen to an example. This is noise with no modulation, or in other words, no contrast present. And this is the same noise with high modulation or high contrast present in the signal. The aim is to identify the lowest contrast level the patient can detect. This is known as the ACT value, and it is expressed in dB/NCL. The lower the ACT value, the better the patient will be able to hear speech in noise, whereas those with a higher ACT value will have more difficulty hearing in noise. This means that patients with higher ACT values will require more from their adaptive hearing aid features than those with lower ACT values. To illustrate this, let's meet two individuals who arrive at a hearing aid clinic with the same Pure Tone Audiogram: Penny and Raul. Penny speaks English and Raul speaks Spanish. ACT allows both individuals to be assessed using the same test. The results from the test show that Raul has a high ACT value. He needs lots of contrast to hear the difference in the signals. Penny, on the other hand, has a low ACT value. She needs very little contrast to hear the difference in the signals. In the real world, this means Raul will experience significant hearing in noise challenges. He will therefore need a lot more help from his hearing aids when listening to speech in noise. As Penny has a low ACT value, she will not need so much help from her hearing aid adaptive features, and these can benefit from being left to focus on the more natural aspects of sound. Although Penny and Raul have the same hearing loss by Pure Tone Audiometry, we need to program their adaptive hearing aid features differently because they have different ACT values. This means that both Penny and Raul can benefit from a personalized hearing aid fitting, which optimizes the hearing aid technology for their individual needs giving the best possible outcomes from their hearing aids with around only 2 additional minutes of testing.